Maggie says she's Guardian angels watch over you both.
You introduce me to noon. As arranged.
Very well, Mr. Van de Gelder. Then I guess there's nothing more for me to do than go back to New York and tell the other girl, the heiress, not to wait.
What did you say?
Nothing. A word.
Heiress?
Particular, Mrs. Levi. I demand particulars. Her name.
Her name? Money. Ernestina Money.
What a lovely name.
Around a silver
ring back.
102. Waist 47.
Waist 47?
Well, that's with her money belt. Now, I can arrange for you to meet Miss Ernestina this very afternoon.
Take my niece Ermengarde, so she forgets a certain Afro temper.
Oh, I could do that for you, Mr. Van Gelder. I know just how to do it. What an amazing coincidence! Guess who's been chosen to ride the main float? The Spirit of 14th Street? Miss Money. Her mother was a cash, you know.
All right, I'll meet Miss Money. But I intend paying a call on Miss Moore first.
Oh, dear, what race did you make me run? Very well, Miss...
It's like Miss Money neither.
This is my own. It's been all good time. Don't you worry.
Oh, woman.
A dainty woman, a sweetheart, a mistress. A what? I think I'll have these walls done over in green wallpaper. Yes, in green. Ermengarde, Ambrose, we have plans to make.
Chief clerk, I'll be promoted to chief, and I still don't get an evening free. Where am I going to begin to live?
You can live on holidays, Cornelius.
Do you forget what we did last Christmas? All those rotten tomato cans went bad and exploded. And you and I cleaned up the mess all afternoon. Do you call that living?
No.
Marty, you and I are going to New York.
You mean close the store?
Uh-huh.
Cornelius,
it's closed.
Holy cabooses, how do you know?
I'm gonna light this candle under them. That's how I know. It'll make such a smell. Customers won't be able to come to the place for 24 hours. That'll get us an evening free. We're going to New York, Barnaby, and we're going to live, and we're going to have a good meal, and we're going to spend all the money, and we're going to be arrested.
Holy cruises.
And one more thing. We're not coming back to Yonkers until we've each kissed a girl.
Cornelius, you can't do that. You don't know any girls.
I'm 33 years old. I have to begin sometime.
I'm only 17, Cornelius. It isn't so urgent for me.
New York, Barnaby. Part of the museum.
A stuffed whale?
A stuffed whale. What do you say, Barnaby?
Yes, Cornelius. Yes.
Now, the first thing to do is make you financially independent. I know. I'll find you a job. Can you dance?
I am an artist, Levi. I paint.
Well, then, my part.
This is Dolly Levi.
Let's see if we can have you both entered into the poker contest tonight. The prize is a week's engagement and a gold cup. Oh, the cups we won.
At the cafe dancing. And I don't mind saying I'm surprised you have acquaintances in a place like that.
Not acquaintances. From in any place you can find it. Cafes, I heard the night like clockwork down the steps of Pneumonia Gardens we came.
Mrs. Levi, I'm addressing Ermengarde to warfare.
It's the only way to show Horace Van de Gelder we mean business. Now, you go to the Harmonia Gardens restaurant this afternoon and say Mrs. Levi sent you. And incidentally, tell Rudolph that Dolly's coming back. And I want a table for two and a chicken for 8 o'clock tonight.
The bar roll looks all right, Cornelius. Now hold the camera under the ones on top. Not too close, the swells up like they're ready to explode. Holy caboose, I can smell it up here.
We're going. Come on, Barnaby. Let's get dressed. We're going to New York.
There. We are there. We are this pink town, Barnaby. There's a slick town, Barnaby.
Love, beauty, and dance, of course.
my word for it, Vinny. Either I marry Horace Vandergelder or I break into this place like a fire engine.
Oh, no.
Not Miss Mortimer again.
Miss Mortimer, I'll take care of it.
No, no. Please. You make another hat for Miss Mortimer. I'm wearing this one myself.
Oh, Mrs. Malone! Oh, the funny hat! Well, that hat is provocative, that's what
it is. Isn't it? Well, who knows who may be coming into the shop today? And provocative, maybe to serve me.
I thought that week.
So you did. Well, so What's the name of these business? I think that's all I said.
What are you talking about?
Yonkers. What a beautiful city it is.
And who's been telling you about Yonkers, might I ask?
Nobody. What do you know, Mr. Vandegelder?
He happens to be my head clergyman, boy. I demand an explanation.
And I'm going to give it to you.
Why should you have Cornelius Hackle? Everybody in New York knows Cornelius Hackle. He appears at opera in all the fashionable homes. Why, he's a...
He's got $146.35 and I keep it in my own safe.
Oh, Mr. Vandegelder, you're killing me. He's one of the Hackle. They built a canal.
What canal?
The ears. We have the wrong
It ain't the same thing.
Took the horses out of Jalen's pairs of bulls on 30th Street, Cornelius Hackle, and who dressed up as a waiter at the Fifth Avenue Hotel and dropped some oysters on Mrs. Astor Cook. I can't say it, but it was Cornelius. He's a playboy of New York. Now, Irene, don't deny it. I can see you were taken with her just like everybody else.
Excuse me?
Of course.
I just don't know what on earth you're saying. Please, I've really seen him only once in my life.
No man that hides in ladies' closets can spare me visibly. My fate is on.
No man indeed. I'm sure you'd make short work of any man, those muscles. I can see them now, rippling back and forth under your coat. Oh, my. God bless you.
This boy?
This man in that closet.
Uh-huh.
And another one on that table.
Good Lord, the whole room's crawling with men. Congratulations, Irene. I take it I'll see you later this afternoon, Mr. Vandegelder.
You certainly will. The first young lady is in the parade. This boy?
Now,
please, Lord, I can explain everything.
I do not wish to hear any explanation.
If you ask me, Irene, calling an officer is letting him out too easy. I've been adding up the legal offense of DTRP minutes, and believe me, you've got grounds for at least 2 weeks. A non-compass menace and a garnache. Now, have dinner with them.
Dinner?
Find that absolutely necessary, darling?
It's the way things are done in the law, Irene. Dinner first, garnish you afterward.
Well, it must be. Mr. Hackle, Mr. Tucker, you may take and stay in my thoughts today.
Be light, Mrs. Lloyd. I think.
I believe that you've already run to dinner with your fashionable friend, what? I hear that a lot before
you. We couldn't go there, Miss Malloy. It's not the money or anything like that. It's just the...
It's the whale.
It's the whale. No, it's the whale, aren't you? It's the dancing. You see, they have dancing in a place like don't have. It would take me weeks, months, years to learn.
Mrs. Dolly Weaver, 33-year-old chief clerk, hot-headed man.
Now, it's simple, Mr. Hackle. You put one arm here and one arm here.
Well, it's no use. I have absolutely no sense of rhythm.
Absolutely no sense of rhythm is one of the primary requirements by learning by the Gallagher-Levi method. Just give me 5 minutes of your time, Mr. Hackle, and I'll have you dancing in the street. We'll start with lesson 7. Welcome to turn. Now, it's simple. Right foot touch, left foot touch, over back, around touch, back around, up, over, release, unfurl. Ooh, the women will find heaven in your arms. Let's go back to lesson 1. Put your hand on her waist and stand. With her right in your left hand and One, two, three. Good. Now back. One, two, three. One, two, great. Three, two, three.
Look here! I'm dancing!
Oh! Well, I was.
Of course you were, Mr. Hackle. Take love, someone who's comes your way. Hold on to her tight and spin. And one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three.
Could you be a little more aesthetic?
Don't you think my dance has a popular pleasure?
Mr. Tucker, keep breathing.
My heart is up.
that I was independent. And then one night, an oak leaf fell out of my Bible. I placed it there when you asked me to marry you. Like one team, not well, I decided to rejoin the human race. And Ethel, I want you to think of
Thank you.
May I put my arm around your waist?
Yes,
but I might as well warn you. Of course, this is horrible. Say so.
Thank you.
George here.
Thank you. you're dismissed. And bless you.
We walk under. It can kill or cure.
in a way, Cornelius. My folly? Yes, we're all fools. And we're all in danger of destroying the world in our folly. But the one sure way to keep us safe is to give 4 of the 5 pleasures there are right in the world. And that takes a little money. The difference between a little amount of money and an enormous amount of money is very big. And, the difference between a little amount of money and no money at all is very slight. And that all can shatter the world. It's all in how you use it. As my late husband, Ephraim Rush, it doesn't mean a thing unless it's spread around encouraging young things to grow. Anyhow, that's the opinion of the second Mrs. Van de Gelder. Which reminds me, Ephraim, I'm ready for that sign.
That goes in there, buddy. Let's go.
Well, as I was saying, Horace, I'm going to be another girl, the ideal wife.
I don't want you to find out on my own. I know I'm going to pull out this more than that other one. But forgive me, Dolly. Mary.
Horace, stop right there.
What do you mean?
Horace, you know as well as I do that you're the first answer me. Am I somebody?
Whoa, what a fool.
Oh, you're partial. I mean, it wouldn't be enough for you to load your wife with money and jewels to make her a benefactress to half the town. By the way, it's bad business letting Cornelius open a store up next to you. You better take him back and make him your partner. And Barnaby can have Cornelius' old job. That way we can all dance at Ermengarde's wedding.
That doesn't all dance its own way. Sigh. I don't know how. I think it weeks.
Oh,
years,
but
I
never thought I'd hear you say a thing like that.
The front row, idiot! The front row!
What is going on in there?
I thought I'd have that room done over in green wall. That guy's just being sensitive in the evening store. I'm always saying, I have a mind. Fine expression. It's like the new.
without them, this play would never have come about. We've all had a great time doing it. And right now, we'd like to pay a tribute to the special people that really helped us a lot.
Oh, is this Smith Ball? She's not here. Okay, well. So start off with the musical of Dr. Brown. And Mrs. Smith Ball's here too. And she kind of forces us to do a lot of things that we thought we couldn't do and still can't. Would you like to play Mrs. Smith? And here you go. Roll it.
Okay, this goes to the lady. Thank you. why for the past 40 years that I will use the triangular sentences and haven't used them yet. Late through this taking your class in set painting because I'm tired of painting them, repainting them, and unpainting them, repainting them. Mr. Tutoy, who's joined us for the first time this year, and without whom we absolutely would not finish the show, he helped me out tremendously. And I guess